got raped by her man and her man's family. And yep. They cut her head off and walking around with her head around the place, you know?
What?
They cut her head off and they're walking around here with
her. Yeah, like, yeah.
Oh, that's pretty crazy.
And then,
he said they cut her head off and was walking around with her head. God damn, bruh. What's the deal, family? Welcome back to the channel. Today we got another banger for y'all, man. So look, we got Inside Darwin's Most Dangerous Housing Estates, Karama and Litchfield Estate into the hood. All right, man, this is brought to us by Spanian. I'm not really sure how to say his name. But I reacted to him before, bro, and he's always going to different hoods, man, mostly in Australia, but he goes to other places too and all that. And y'all seem to like the video. I got a lot of Australian followers on my my main reaction channel, so they seem to like when I drop these over here, so I'm gonna run up another one for y'all. But basically, he travels to Northern Territory of Australia in search of Darwin's most dangerous hood. What he finds along the way will shock you, all right? So let's get to it. Y'all make sure, man, if you like the video, hit that like button if you like the reaction. If you guys want to check out more of his videos, he has a whole bunch of them, man. Make sure to go tap in with him. He almost got 500K, so he really does some dope videos, so go check him out, man. But let's get into it. Inside Karama and Litchfield Estates.
It's like being in a prison. So the council come and put this up for this house because...
done something under the influence of alcohol.
So this is a police box full of cameras.
This mob didn't want to look after her, they slit her throat.
He was walking with a head, the alcohol.
A head?
Shut up.
I'm Spanian. I was raised in the housing areas of Sydney City. Spent most of my youth and adult life in prison. And after a total of 13 years, I'm free and I'm out and about, flying around, sussing out the hoods all over the world. Doge.
Welcome back to Into the Hood. I'm in Darwin, the capital of the Northern Territory of Australia. There's a place here named Karama. Apparently the violent assault rate has increased by nearly 100% in the past 6 years. This is the hood of this place. This is the most dangerous area. I got in contact with this lad from Instagram. He's from there. He grew up there and he's gonna take me around there. We're going to meet him now. He goes, there's a few spots, but this is the main one. Everyone here knows it. It's on the news all the time, blah, blah, blah. So I looked in the maps, right? And I seen another suburb next to it named Malak, and it looked just as bad. So I said this to him, this is really interesting. I go, mad, bro, so we'll go around Karama and we'll go through that suburb next to it, Malak. And he goes to me, he goes, nah, we won't go through there. We'll just go through Karama and we'll walk past the side of Malak and I go, all right. He goes, yeah, there'll just be tension. It won't be good if we walked in there, but I'll show you around Karama, and then we'll go down the street to this place named Litchi, and this is this big house.
That reminds me of LA. Just like when he said that, and I mean, there's a lot of, there's really any hood in the world, bro, but, you know, just because you in one hood don't mean you can go to another hood, because the dude you might be with, he might have some beef with dudes from the other hood, or they might not let outsiders in, so he can't just... you know, at least in Los Angeles, you know what I mean? You can't just go anywhere you want to go because you might have enemies. There might be people that know you from the other side over there. So it might be some problems, man.
Housing estate that everyone hangs out at, which is just a big...
But that's how you know it's bad, too. Because if you can just go anywhere, then is it like, is it really all that dangerous in that hood? If you can't go from one area to another area, that's how you know, okay, it could be bad over here for real.
Get out of both of those suburbs. I go, all right, sweet, nah, all right, whatever, you know, like, that's all good. Then he got at me today, that was yesterday. He goes, all right, I've organized with a few of the boys, they're gonna be with me, so we'll go from Karama and we'll walk through Malak as well. So now we are walking through Malak.
Okay.
And then I go, all right, sick, yeah, mad. So I don't know the story, I didn't ask too much, I'll ask him when I see him, but apparently if you're from Karama, you don't wanna be taking people through Malak and vice versa. Then I said, yeah, I'm coming to meet you, sweet, we organized that. Then he goes, just one thing, bro, that just don't wear red clothes. I was gonna wear this anyway, regardless. My outfit's blue, so, and then, so it made me think, is there some type of red and blue thing? And then I'm like, should I not be wearing blue? I don't know what's going on. But apparently, we almost weren't gonna go in the other suburb, and I shouldn't be wearing red. So that sets the tone of this place anyway. There's a lot of interesting facts. Gang brawls in this place. This place has the highest car theft rate in Australia.
Yes.
Going off per capita of registrations, registered vehicles, it's by far the highest car theft. Apparently everyone's just flying around here like maniacs. And as the rest of the country slowly gets better and better, this place, the Northern Territory in general, is getting worse and worse.
Hey, how are you? Is this where I buy a bus?
Sound like New Jersey.
Yeah. To going to Karama.
Oh, to Karama.
Karama. All right, I'm saying it wrong. Yeah. Karama. Thank you.
Spanish, you're saying it wrong, mate. It's not Karama, it's Karama.
Karama.
Relax, mate. Bang, lad. Number 10. Oh, five's down there. Catch a five from down there. While we're sitting here, I'll show you where we are in respect to these places. So we're here, where the blue dot is, obviously. And in the northern suburbs above the airport, this is where these places are. The red dot is Karama. That place next to it is Malak. And the other place we're going to is down this road, the Litchi housing estate. So yeah, it's all on the north side. These suburbs are all up on the north side of Darwin, above the airport.
All right, here's the bus. Five, let's go. Wait, is it five?
Yes, it's five. Well, now I know you just walk on without saying anything. I wouldn't have even bought a ticket. Now I got a ticket, I walk on, don't say nothing.
He got scared, he was like, hey.
Then I had no ticket and sat there making a fuss about it. Hey, where do I get a ticket from? Bloody hell. You see how secure these buses are? Bus driver behind a full cage down there. Cameras everywhere, bro. Look how so full.
Oh, they got the cameras in there. I don't think I ever seen a bus with cameras in it. For real.
Googled Karama and the Wikipedia comes up. Karama, Northern Territory. Karama is a crime-ridden suburb. First sentence of Wikipedia. It's well known as one of Darwin's hotspots of crime. Crimes against the person and public order offences. That's the Google breakdown of where we're going. Bro, look, I'm reading just recent examples on here of crimes. All in the last 2 years. 17-year-old man stabbed, 19-year-old man stabbed, found with a 15-inch knife hanging out of
God
his back.
Damn!
A 23-year-old man approached a 3-year-old child. Don't even want to read that one.
Yeah.
Businesses shutting their doors. People rioting against the businesses, locking themselves up. 20-year-old man died and a woman was seriously injured following two stabbing incidents in Karama. Two men attacked with pipes and edge weapons during a brawl in Karama streets. A woman in her 40s found dead at a bush camp in Karama. Police, look how many there are, bro. That's all in the last 2 years. It's actually a bit more serious than I thought going to this.
I mean, honestly, bro, in comparison to dudes getting shot and shit like that, like, because in California, LA, bro, people just be getting shot. Like, but it was just like 3-4 days ago, bro. There's a chopper going up over the crib. Police everywhere, bro. The homie pulled up on me. I'm like, he like, what's going on? I'm like, I don't even know, dog, but something happened. I come to find out, bro, somebody shot somebody and was on the run. And then they got pulled up on and gave up probably like a mile down the street, mile down the road or whatever. But the bird was right up over the crib. I'm like, God damn, police everywhere, too. They looking at me. They looking at the homie. I'm like, hey, we ain't got nothing to do with nothing. We chilling, bro. Hey, what's up? We good, bro. But, you know what I mean? Not saying stabbing is cool. That's fucked up, too. That's really fucked up and a little bit more intimate, but. You know, cats just be getting shot up over there. You know what I mean? It's hard to run from bullets. It's hard to run from bullets, bro. So
this place. Now I'm thinking twice of when I said, all right, we'll go through Malak. And he's like, no, we won't go through there because we're from this side. But I'll take you near the edge. we're good. That's Oj.
Shit, to be real. One of my good friends, bro, his mom just got robbed at the mall by a bunch of dudes. Robbed her and all that shit. And it could have been way worse, you know what I'm saying? Like, it could have been way worse if she decided she wanted to fight back or whatever like that. And, you know, so, And that's not even where I live and where that happened at. It's not even a bad area, bro. Like, it's not even, like, the worst of L.A., you know what I mean? So, be careful in them hoods, bro. Be careful in them hoods.
We're not far now. It's just pretty much up the end of this road, then left. See, huh? And it's going to turn left, go up there.
Let's go.
That's Karama. Karama, I don't know. Let's see the ear on the right.
We're getting off here, bro. Let's go.
Hey. I feel like I got off one step, stopped too early. But we got to make Levi up where this red dot is. Up.
Get your walk on,
so
man.
So tropical this weather. It's so bad.
And the whole thing's like fenced the whole way. Bruh. There's no back of the houses though. All right, yeah, that's a lane in. Look at the lanes, bro. Look.
The lanes are fenced. Like they get locked certain hours.
Yeah. Yeah. No coming in, no
Active
coming out.
Used,
they get padlocked up. Lanes only like a few hours a day. Yes, this is a lane, only between 6 and 8 p.m. I wonder what that's about. Definitely has to do with having control in police chases. 100%.
Yep. Some shit goes down, oh, lock no. it up. Oh, shit.
It's all got spikes on it, lad.
God damn.
Like, all right, you fence...
That shit is like a jail.
...their lane certain hours, but spikes on it, what? We seen people use the lane after hours. None of that, mate.
It's like a residential jail or some shit. Like,
I tell you something straight off the bat, what I noticed here, and I noticed that when we went in the hood in Palmerston, every single front yard, every single house is completely surrounded by a high fence. Every single one.
That's how you know.
Forget having no fences or even low fences. Every single... There's security fence around every single place. Even like the poor ones, they've got like... school fences around them. That tells a lot that 100% of the houses are completely fenced in.
It does.
And some of them even blocked out.
Probably got guard dogs and all the shit, at least in LA.
Bro, full sharp even. They're sharp. They're proper sharp, bro. You can't put body weight on that. That's proper sharp.
Look at the barbed wire, bro.
Hey, how you doing?
How
we doing, lad? Oh, here we are at the shops, yeah. What's doing?
Oh,
hey, doing, lad? How are you?
What's up, buddy? How are you?
What's your name?
Zane.
Everybody got blue on.
What's going on, bro?
Doing, lad. Doing. Hello, mate. How are you?
Think is that security?
Yeah, let's go. Hello. He's all from you?
Yeah,
hectic. Take me into the hood, lad.
All right, bro. This is where it all started anyway, bro. Like, Karama Shopping Center.
Yeah.
It's not as bad as it used to be, but...
Yo.
One of my best mates got stabbed and killed over there.
Damn.
Yeah?
Bro. When I was rolling around as a youngin, cuss, there used to be axe fights in the car park around here, bro. Still is, if you ask the security, bro.
Bro, when I was on the way on the bus, I searched up this place on Wikipedia.
Yeah.
And all it is just this bloke died, this bloke got stabbed, this bloke... Hey, go on, mate. This bloke got stabbed, this woman got found dead, these two people... Not long ago, two people got stabbed, someone had a knife hanging out their back.
Yeah, it's got a fucking bad rap, bro.
Man, they true to the blue. They got on blue shorts, blue shirts, blue hats, blue Powerade, blue Gatorade, blue drink, blue laces, blue shoes, blue whatever. No, I probably got blue cars.
Like, mostly in Darwin anyway, it's like... Housing spread out, bro. We don't have places like Mount Druitt, you know, where it's like dense fucking housing.
Yeah.
It's like, if I walk you down the road, bro, it'll be like, nice house, housing commission,
nice house.
Like, we're spread out into like, you know, but fucking Karama probably has like the more dense housing commission. I think that's why the crime's higher.
Yeah.
You know?
So at all the places, this has the densest.
Yeah.
So and like, this is the most notorious area here. Everything I've searched up says this place.
Yeah, well, it depends on who you ask.
So in the LA comparison, it's like the difference between like Watts and like Compton. Because Compton really is a suburb, but it's the hood. But Compton used to be like all white people, like rich white people suburbs, but then they moved them out And all the black people used to live in, like, Watts and shit. So Watts has a bunch of, like, projects. Bunch of projects, whatever, housing, estates, whatever you want to call it. You know what I mean? And in Compton, it's, like, houses. It's all houses and suburbs, you know what I mean? And all that. So that's what it sounds like he's saying. Like, this place is more like a Compton type of area versus Mount Druitt, which is more projects, is more like a like Watts type of area.
Bro,
yeah,
a lot of in Palmo think they're like, you know,
yeah.
A lot of Casways think they're more, bro. It's like, but
yeah,
you know, if you Google it, it says what it says, bro.
Yeah. So, this is the local shops,
yeah. This is the local shops. You can come inside if you want, bro.
Yeah, we'll have a sus. Let's go.
So, I've lived everywhere, bro. I've lived fucking Palmerston, I've lived in Maldon, bro, which is like meant to be Darwin's, like Palmerston's worst.
Yeah, that's where I was.
Yeah,
Maldon.
Yeah, so I've lived in Maldon, bro. I've lived in Karama. I lived in Cas, bro.
Yeah.
From my experience, anyway, Karama's the worst.
Maldon. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hey.
Even nice. Ask this big fella how Karama is, bro.
That's fucking shit.
Yeah?
That's 100% shit.
Yeah, like even those flats over there, bro.
They're all new.
They're new, but they're low income housing.
Oh, are they?
Yeah. They're not like public housing, but they're low income.
Yeah.
So if you make below
like
the
subsidized,
bracket, you
know? Subsidized housing. Yeah.
Yeah. So like when I was growing up, that was all just like a dirt patch. You cut through to come to the shop.
Yep.
But now it's like low income housing. At the back of the shops is like the public housing. So like
that
the bad housing.
Yep.
We'll cut through here anyway.
Everywhere's like that though. They have the newer, nicer flats. Yes,
right,
people think they're rich flats, but they're actually like low income, subsidized.
Yeah, you'd be surprised, man. Just because it's new don't mean it's
too much.
Good.
Oh,
They'll get you with that. It'll look nice because it's brand new, but everybody in there broke.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
Why?
Because the crime was so bad. Like when I was growing up here, my mate died in the car park.
Yeah.
There was axe fights in the car park, all at night time.
Yep.
So like there now, they patrol with canine unit at night time between a certain time.
Damn, just they got canines?
Just in this car park. Yeah.
So this car park was a spot where lads would come up here and punch on them.
So like I said to you on Instagram, bro, like back when Malak versus Karama was a big thing or like...
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. Because when I said, let's go Malak, you were at the start, you were a bit like, alright, we'll go,
yeah.
What's the yarn there?
Well, like back in the day, it used to be bad. Like say boys from Karama, or like boys from Karama that have mates from elsewhere would take trips to Malak to fuck with them boys and like vice versa, you know, like it's not like a bad fucking beef where we go back and forth killing each other, but it was just a sort of a fucking tension, you know?
But just enough to not just cruise around freely.
Like I wouldn't walk around Malak by myself at night time because I don't know who the fuck I'm gonna see, but.
Yo. And has that eased up a bit?
Well, like most of the boys don't go around here anymore, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And what's this? You said something about wearing red, lad. You made me paranoid.
Just around Litchis, bro. You're fine in Karama, just around Litchis, bro.
Litchis?
Yeah, Litchis. The,
so they got a little
courts,
color code like, thing going on.
Yeah.
All right.
Forever changing, bro.
Yeah.
Probably going to be different in 10 years.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a park down here where punch-ons always used to fucking happen, bro. All sorts of random shit. Just kicking back drinking. We'd start drinking in the shopping centre, like, around the car park and shit, and then we'd get moved on, and then it moves to the park, and then that's when the night ends, you know?
Yeah.
Always been a tension between Darwin suburbs, because like I said, like, it's spread out. Like, there was Cas versus Palmerston beef.
So, well,
like,
where's Cas?
Cas is Casuarina, so, like, Casuarina. This sort of area is sort of considered Casuarina.
Yep.
Like, more city boy sort of thing. And then Palmerston is, like...
Palmerston's, like, the next town down.
Sort of thing. So, like, there was Palmo boys and Cas boys. And that used to be the big thing. So Palmo boys would come to Cas and fight with the Cas boys would go Palmo boys, you know.
Oh, really?
Bus depot beef type
constant,
shit.
Yeah.
These flats aren't even as bad as they used to be, bro.
Yeah.
Same as like, in not too long ago, like 3 weeks ago, we had a big housing estate that got knocked down.
Oh,
that was called the Narrows.
Yeah.
That was like Mad Max, bro.
The Narrows, yeah. The Narrows. Sound like
I was rocking around the Narrows. That was Mad Max, bro.
The Narrows.
Like, everywhere, like disgust.
Like you'd rock up there, bro, and there's fucking zombies in the car park, like, you know.
Oh, that's it.
Drugs and all that.
See what I mean? How like those flats are fucking trashy.
Yeah.
It's got the nice flats.
Yeah.
We're all sort of mixing together. It sort of makes like the crime.
The trappers here.
And also, I don't know if you did like if you knew or not, but NT's the fucking highest murder rate per capita in Australia.
Is it?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Too long ago, yeah.
So Northern Territory's highest murder rate per capita in Australia.
Yeah.
I knew that it was the most car thefts.
Yeah.
I got told that by someone. So it's the highest murder rate and the most car thefts in Australia.
So per capita though, we only have like 150,000
people. Oh, of course per capita. Yeah, of course.
Yeah, this is the park where all the fucking old shenanigans used to happen.
Yeah.
I wouldn't go to Alice. That's just...
got it, bro.
Alice is shit everywhere.
Every hood got a park, man.
I'm going.
You going, Alice?
Sometime in the next 2 months, I'm going. Yeah. I had to go back overseas, and then, of course.
Walk around at night time, bro.
It's full on. Now.
Is it?
Alice is full on, bro.
Like, oh, yeah?
Especially at night time, bro. It's full
on. Last time I went to Alice, bro, like during the daytime. Only white people, they look like they're going on business trips and shit, you know?
Yeah.
As soon as it turns nighttime, bro, it's like you should stay in your hotel, you know? And like, it feels like when oldies are floating through the streets, bro, like,
in what
fighting in car parks.
So. You tell me, but what specific parts, or is it down the in
oh,
the
well,
town?
Oh, well, like, Alice Main Street. Yeah, so there's like one main street, you know
yeah.
what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then, like, that is the main street yeah. for everything, so.
Because I'm, daytime, I'm it's fine. That's what I had planned. I had planned two places here, this place. And Palmerston
yeah.
and two places in Alice Springs.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's one in Alice Springs and then someone else told me somewhere just outside of it.
You're talking about Port Keats? No. Don't go to Port Keats.
But I don't remember the name of it. Someone said something about rock and roll gangs or some shit.
Oh yeah, that's Port Keats, yeah.
It is?
Don't go to Port Keats.
Yeah,
you'll probably get shot, like, speared, like, you know.
Legit,
those are the ones that come to Karama, like, they're the community boys, we call them anyway.
Yeah.
And that's where all the axe fights would happen and shit. So community boys come from the communities, come here and start shit, you know, and then that sort of shit would go on.
Port Keats, mate, if I go there, I'm getting crossbowed. Anyone watching from Port Keats, when I show up, I'm nice and friendly.
yeah, you better be cool in Port Keats.
Oh, yeah?
Bro, they got gangs that are called, like, Metallica, like,
yeah,
Iron Maiden and shit.
Yeah, yeah,
like Mad Max there, bro. Like, I've got mates who went there for work, bro, and like they have to have like a cage around their fucking rooms because their shit will just get broken into, and like
no
over
way
the night,
that's
hear
crazy
shit in houses and shit.
Who gave me this idea? So I can't remember. Someone told me go there. He's trying to set yeah. me up, mate.
Karama used to be really active. My mate Dylan got stabbed in the car park and passed away.
Yeah.
And then that's when everyone sort of stopped kicking around Karama, and now it's mostly community boys.
What do you mean by that, community boys?
So boys that come from the community.
Oh, okay,
like
okay.
Like kids, like all the outside, outskirt communities.
Yeah.
Because they're a lot worse there than like,
yeah.
you know, like
yeah, yeah,
you can't
yeah.
even compare Mount Druitt to it because it's,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
like a third world country out there, bro.
Yeah. All right, so community yeah. boys is just like lads from rural towns, yeah. and they come in here and run amok.
Proper
yeah.
run right. amok.
Yeah,
they
yeah.
can't, like, really out there, they're banned alcohol completely, like zero alcohol communities.
Yeah.
So you have to have like a fucking like a ticket sort of thing, like you
yep,
have to be
yep, yep.
able to have it, so they can't get alcohol out there.
Yep.
So when they come in, they get f***ing munted off their face, and it's like,
yeah,
yeah, they start doing bad shit.
All right, community boys.
A lot of them come up here.
Damn, you know it's wild if you can't even have alcohol in the whole community. Like in the community, you can't have no alcohol. That's kind of, I ain't never heard no shit like that. That's crazy. They definitely couldn't do that over here. It ain't no way you could do that. They just niggas just gonna go somewhere else, go get it, and bring it back anyway. Like.
Just to get locked up and shit as well.
Yeah.
There's the two jails in the Northern Territory.
Can you imagine how full Alice
yeah.
is too?
So there's yeah. Alice Springs Jail, yeah. and then there's Darwin Jail, which is in, it's in Barramarai. Am I tripping? No, Holt.
Nah,
Holt, yeah.
Yeah.
So, that, like,
so the whole
two.
State, two prisons?
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
And it's like, I'd say like...
Yeah, they must be packed.
Yeah, it's like 80...
And New South Wales is like...
Yeah, it's like 80 or 90% Aboriginals.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So they've run the... Yeah, bro, you can't...
Yeah, yeah, I can imagine.
Yeah,
yeah, we got... In New South Wales, it's like 29 prisons.
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
Damn!
Yeah, 29 men's prisons. That's
29 prisons!
Males and not including juvies. It's 29 yeah. adult males, yeah. And some of them are massive. Like, some of the big ones in Sydney have like 1,500 inmates. They got like 32 wings and stuff, yeah. yeah.
Shit.
So two, I can imagine,
yeah.
be over the top.
And like no aircon, no nothing, and it's like, you can imagine in this heat having no aircon in a concrete box.
Yeah.
You only get-
I can imagine.
You can't have your own shoes, no fucking nothing.
Heat is the worst in jail.
Yeah.
And I've never experienced heat like this. Like I've been in some hot jails, but mate, this would be torture in this weather.
Yeah, Alice Springs is pretty hot, but it, like, it's a desert, so nighttime it gets cold. So,
yeah.
Like, so here it's like tropical more so tropical anyway, so
yeah,
it's
yeah.
like humid.
Yeah.
So you're like sticky as
yeah,
fuck.
Yeah, that's the worst thing about
yeah.
here. Like I've been hot places, but it's wet.
Yeah.
Like I'm wet.
Especially this time of the year too. Like you come here in the build up, bro. We got
yeah,
two
yeah.
seasons, so it's like wet season, dry season. Dry season's the coldest of the seasons because it's not humid, but
yeah.
that's it, they're both hot.
Yeah. Why do they do that? This one's actually locked.
So in my street that I grew up on, we didn't have that at first.
Yeah.
So once crime like sort of spikes on a street, they'll build it. And then like they'll lock it over certain times, like a curfew sort of thing. So you have to walk out like the one exit of the street.
So that's a punishment.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's crazy.
So
that's crazy.
They build them like that, And if crime happens, then they lock yous and they give yous a curfew. Yeah, yeah. And what, like, do they unlock it after when yous are good or something?
In the daytime.
Yeah. Yeah. And then if the crime lowers, do they stop taking, do they leave it open at night?
No, it'll just stay up. It's like, just permanent. Mine's still there to this day, bro. They built it when I was like 10.
So
you know the security that drive around in cars?
Yeah, yeah.
They lock it at like 10 p.m.
Yeah.
They're everywhere. There's heaps in Palmerston out here.
Why is this one closed even in the day then? Is it been extra bad up there or something?
Probably, bro.
They've been naughty up there, mate. Yeah, no more lanes.
I'm not gonna lie, that's fucked. That's super fucked because... Nigga, what if somebody coming at you, dog? Like, imagine somebody coming at you and you just trying to get away, bro. You just trying to run. You doing your dash, bro. You like, I'm trying to get up out of here, dog. At this point, the only other way out, if you can't get, because you can't get, and you got to climb up them motherfuckers. They got the barbed wire, the spikes on it, bro. You can't get up over that gate. You got to go hop through other people's yards because they got smaller gates. So then you got to hop through other people's shit just to get away so you don't get stabbed up. But now you might walk into somebody's backyard and they might stab you up for going in their backyard. So it's really fucked. I don't know. Maybe it does help, but I don't think it does. If anything, it just make people feel like they more you treat people like animals, they gonna act more like animals. That's how I see it. You treat people like animals, you make them feel like animals, they just gonna act more like animals. And you might cause more problems than you do good. But I could be wrong. I could be wrong. I don't really know, but that just seemed like if I was getting chased down and I boom, 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 I bust the right. If I bust the wrong right or the wrong left, now I'm it's this chained up wall. I'm on a dead end basically. And I got five dudes with 15 with big ass knives trying to get me. I'm fucked. Versus if it's open, I can still do my dash. If I'm faster than them, I'm gone. I don't know. Y'all let me know what you think in the comments though. I'm about to reset though real quick.
It's a Mordai, bro.
Oh yeah?
Crossbar in the knee, in the arm, bro. They're on the oval shooting them at each other.
Wait, what?
Yeah, it's fucking hectic there, bro. That's like their gangs, bro. Like they're setting their own fucking houses on fire, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's like, I think that's one of the fucking like hardcore gangs there.
Yeah, that's mental.
Yeah.
So what's down here? We're going to Malak?
Yeah.
All right. Malak.
That's the place where, like, for a long time, people would burn potties and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
So there used to just be f***ing trashed cars in the car park, like, spazzing out. Like, it's not as... Same as the rest of Darwin, bro. It's not as bad as it used to be, but it's still pretty whack.
Yeah.
More like alcohol, bro. Like I said, like, community mob come here, get on the alcohol, and then because they can't get it where they're from, it f***s them, you know?
Yeah.
So, what's that? Tell me... We've got domestic violence here, too.
Bad domestic violence.
Yeah, really bad.
That's because a lot of the Aboriginal communities struggle with alcoholism.
Yep.
So, like, they try and make the communities dry, but then again, you've got people still, like, taking bottles from them in town and sneaking them out in the communities, and then they sell them for double out in the community.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
So they might buy, I don't know.
So there's a little black market out in the communities.
Yeah. Pretty much, yeah.
And there's bad domestic violence, like, they start bashing their missus and stuff like that.
A lot of the fucking murders in Darwin, bro, like, around this area as well, are from domestic violence.
Oh, like partners. Like,
that bloke who got stabbed at the shops.
Yo. I know it's crazy because some people are just shit people, bro. You know what I mean? Some people just ain't shit, bro. But also, it's like, if they got, you know, that's why communities that have, like, different things and outlets you can do always thrive more. You thrive more when there's activities and things to do outside of, outside of just sitting there. You're just sitting there. So fuck it. You're going to get drunk. You're going to keep getting drunk. You're going to get more drunk. You're going to keep drinking. You're going to start drinking more. And it's going to be bad, bro. Alcoholism is not cool, bro. I've dealt with that in my life. Abusing alcohol and shit. Like, it's not cool. You know what I'm saying? It's not cool. And it don't really take you nowhere good, especially if you're abusing it. For real, for real. So, but when you got nothing else to do, shit. And if you take it away, it's just gonna make people go binge. Cause then when they can't get it, they gonna down the whole motherfucker. Cause they can't drink it. It's kind of childlike, to be honest. But I don't know, man. That's a whole nother deeper conversation that there ain't. You know, it's gonna be hard to find answers to that.
That was stabbed as well. That was like, you know, it was like over that girl. So that was sort of a domestic violence situation.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, it's, so that sort of shit, bro.
And is that most of the reason why they banned alcohol from these communities, or?
I think so, bro.
Yeah.
I think so, because, like, it's weird. You're allowed alcohol out there, but you have to take the routes to get it. Like, you got to sign your name on the papers, give it to the police, and, like, the police, you know, like, give you the fucking permit or whatever.
That's crazy.
You can take the permit in and pay for your grog and they barge it over, you know, shit like that.
Yeah, yeah.
But there's no like stores out there. And if you don't have a permit, you can't drink, you know?
When you think of it,
that's wild.
Alcohol in the communities back in the day.
Yeah, yeah.
It was old proper living off the land out there.
Yeah.
And the BDR here is bad. And like, I could go some places in Sydney, they won't even.
What the BDR is.
They won't ask me for ID. Like,
and drinking register.
Yeah.
What is it? So BDR, yeah?
Drinking register. So we need to show our ID every time we get alcohol and scan it to see if we're banned.
Yeah.
Oh, like, no way. And that's an offender. That's like a
territory government thing. Yeah. They'll put you on the BDR. So, like, if I get done with, like, a couple bad assaults or something, they'll put me on the BDR. If it's like alcohol related, I'll be banned from drinking for like 2 years, you know?
Nah,
yeah, what? Like that. That's
so
crazy.
Every time I go to the bottle,
BDR,
it doesn't matter if you're like
banned drinking
woman, you have
register.
To scan your ID. Yeah.
I never heard of that in my life.
Alcoholic and you just had an alcohol
in
the city,
yeah.
For it, they're like, okay, you get banned.
And so, like, obviously, anyone domestic violence and all of that type of stuff would be on it.
A little scared.
Yeah, so fucking BDR is pretty bad.
On to you. Yeah.
Hey, that was fresh.
These could be Housing Commission or they could have been bought from Housing Commission.
Yep.
So say you're living in it for like 12 years, the government will like ask you if you want to buy it for like crazy cheap, you know?
Yep.
Yeah, that's amazing. It's so like, these would be all Housing Commission houses at least at some point.
Yeah,
just by like
Yeah, let's go suss that out. So whole.
I think, yeah.
All right, so they said Housing Commission. Same thing with Compton. When black people first started moving into Compton, they were basically giving away houses for free. So a lot of people coming from like the South and shit or other places, boom, they was getting the houses in Compton and shit and flooding it up because they were just trying to sell it for cheap because all the white people was moving out. And then so that's how Compton became a thing. So that's why I was saying like this is kind of like Compton area, even though this is, I think, Milwaukee or maybe they still in Karama. I'm not really sure, but that's what I was saying earlier about that.
Yeah, that's
whole houses and whole like areas get banned from alcohol, like if they play up. It seems like, you know what it seems like? Between this banning whole houses from drinking and locking up lanes, it seems like this whole place is getting treated like a minimum security prison.
Yeah.
Like you gotta behave and then you get your rights, you know what I mean?
And you get fines.
So the council come and put this up for this house because
that's crazy.
They punched on or something.
Occupants, like, you know, have, you know, done something under the influence of alcohol, you know?
They're just drinking that much and causing problems.
Bro,
that's wild, bro.
Can you believe that? They full come and put up a sign on the front of your house and your whole house isn't allowed to drink and your neighbors are allowed to drink.
That's
it's crazy, bro.
And you'll pass me the bottle over the fence, dog. Throw me a bottle, dog.
Oh, really? A group called the Jovi Boys, bro. The Bon Jovi Boys.
Yeah.
They come in from one community, bro, and they're like, they come here and they like, they use hammers and fucking screwdrivers to steal like big four drives.
Yep.
And they take them back out to the community and like, fuck them up.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah, there's like Facebook pages of like fucking public heroes Facebook that want to get them, you know?
Oh, really?
But they also roll around with axes and shit.
Yeah.
But it's like, would you rather your car or get hit by an axe in your head in your own house?
Yeah,
you can have
so they sneak in at night, grab your keys, grab your stuff off your bench, take your car.
You get comfortable, bro. Like, even now, I've moved to a nicer
What do you call
suburb.
That? Do you call that caddies? Yeah, caddies. Yeah, that's all.
Boys are driving up to these units here and then just like start on sort of there, you know what I mean, sort of thing? Like tit for tat sort of shit. Same with the Casboy Palmo boy shit.
Yeah. Wait, so in the Casboys versus Palmo, would yous be sweet with the Malak boys to fight the Palmo boys?
It's weird, bro, because like, you know, people in Malak don't really claim Casboys. Some of them do.
Oh, they don't?
Yeah. It's weird.
Because he's only one suburb away, like.
Yeah. Those things that kicked off like in more recent years, bro, like when 1-4 and shit started blowing up.
Yep.
Started using weapons.
Like oh, yeah.
4
boys and shit like that. It wasn't
shout
like
out 1-4, man.
Even 1-4 was an influence on that.
No, like around that time.
They're not gonna like hearing that, mate.
It is what it is.
No,
man.
Like around that time, you know. So like, everyone was making the music, not just them.
Yeah.
But everyone's like getting hyped up in the head. They're like, yeah, Shanks and Shiv.
Just
you know?
In, yeah.
Yeah. If, like, if these guys do it, I'm gonna fucking do it. You know?
1-4, 21, 2-7.
It was mostly punch on, bro.
Yeah.
And then Mountie, all that.
Like, one group brings a knife, obviously, then like, the other group's gonna bring a knife next time, you know?
Yeah. Well, I think unfortunately in Sydney it went from stabbings to just shooting each other in the head.
Yeah. Shootings here aren't that bad. Like, in Palmo, some of this shit happens, bro. It's mostly like drug fueled though.
Yeah.
Like ice. You know, ice is fucking bad here.
Ice, man. Yeah.
Ice is bad.
Stay away from
that. That's
what
the boys were saying in Palmo, that ice lately has gotten bad.
Stay the fuck away from that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Boarded up. Yeah. Another restricted premises. I can't believe that they surprises me that they even have that power. Like the
insane
state government has that power to single out people like that. And not only that, but display it to the public.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Like put a sign on the front of their house. That's putting them on show. That's like stigmatizing them. Yeah. It's all right. Like, all right, one thing's bad enough to ban the house, but not put a fucking sign on their front door.
Exactly.
So you walk past and you know who the drunks are. That's stupid, bro.
Oh, treating people like animals. Like I said, that shit does not help. It don't help, in my opinion, bro. It don't help.
12 is the tag every.
That's like back in, you know, back in the day when they used to make kids who were bad in school, they make them wear the little dunce hats and shit. Like that was a thing back in the day, or even way back in the day. This is before I was growing up or whatever, but I've heard stories from family members, uncles, you know, older people and stuff. Like, bro, they used to like whip kids in front of the other students. Like, that's fucked up. You know what I mean, man? Let the parents go deal with that at the crib. They can go whoop their ass if they want, but in front of everybody else, make them wear hats because they stupid and shit. Like, that's fucked up. Real talk. It don't help. It don't help at all.
Everywhere?
0812, yeah.
Mostly like in Karama rep 0812. I think Malak sort of on the border.
That looks like a project.
Oh, so the Northern Territory's postcode start with 0.
Yeah, 0. All right,
yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely a project.
Central's not as bad anymore. Like, you see more of the, like, it's from Karama hanging out on my lap and shit like that nowadays. Palmer boys hang out with Kaz boys now.
Yeah.
Weird shit.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. It's good, but like they still fight. Like,
oh, they still fight though?
It's majority of the youngers.
Yeah.
Like, it's not like 18. Shit change. It's like 15-year-olds, 16-year-olds just
stupid. Yeah.
Imagine grabs the bad here, bro.
Yeah.
From, like the shops and shit.
Yeah.
Ask any like small business owner here, bro. They fucking hate it.
Oh, they get terrorized?
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
Ram raids, bro. Like, in Wongari, which is a couple suburbs over, had a fucking forklift ram raid.
I was about to say that.
Yeah.
Forklift one.
Like, they stole their own forklift and rammed it through the back gate.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Damn. Because
they left the keys in the fucking forklift. And youth crime's bad here because it's a slap on the wrist, bro.
Is it?
Youth does very good.
Yeah, this suburb does look heaps bad, eh? It's a full rundown. Oh, yeah? These are the shops?
Yeah.
Caltex.
People here are just so used. The front of every shop will just have some bloke doing something weird. You know what I mean? Like, it's like, bro, are you passing out? Are you okay?
A majority is alcohol with the indigenous, unfortunately.
Yeah.
We struggle with alcohol issues.
What is that alarm? It's going off
again. You know those,
those fucking boxes.
Like there.
What is that?
One of the police boxes they set up with the cameras?
Yeah.
No.
If you walk too close to it, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, no, it's here. What is that? Is that the police box there?
Yeah,
I want to go see this. We've got to go see this. That's one there, right? On the
fuck is it going on for?
No, no. We've also got trailers.
Oh, you've got to show me.
Even those, if you walk too close to those, depending on where they are, it will tell you to fuck off.
Show me it, bro. That's crazy. So little portable police towers.
Yeah, they have got the ones on trailers as well.
But when you think about, like, they've got these cameras here, but sometimes it gets, like, busy that they legit bring in a trailer with more cameras on it.
So this is a police box, megaphones on it, full of cameras. One of them a rotating camera. And what? Tell me exactly what it... Oh, it's to watch the bottler. And so what does it do? It watches people and starts talking
to
them.
It's live feed, too.
It's live feed. The one that moves is live feed.
Yep.
They'll talk through there.
And what are they actually speak through that?
Sometimes, say it's like 2 a.m, I've seen guns walk past it, and then it's like, you're under police surveillance, like, get out of it, like, you know, sort of thing.
So it's a copper in some place, and he's going, mate, I'm watching.
Ass for the race.
Yeah.
That was wild.
And then you, like, see punching on, and the copper's, mate, stop it, we're coming.
It'll tell you, please.
That's wild, bro.
And so that's one that's fixed. You said that they even have.
So like,
is there any around? We gotta. If we find one, you've gotta show me that.
They used to have one up against that.
Yeah.
They
have them in car parks.
Set them up for the most random places.
Do they?
Yeah, they drive them up into a park.
I can't believe that, bro.
That's crazy, bro.
Or else the alarm goes off. It sounds like that.
And so a light goes off and everything. Yeah. I want them to talk to us.
Yeah. Throw something at it.
Say hello to YouTube. Coppers, you're on YouTube. Say hello, mate. Oh, no way.
Yeah. Yeah, and then it's got like a big pole up with more cameras on it.
That pole like goes up.
So it extends up.
Yeah.
And they park it and it pretty much does that, yeah. But portable.
Yeah.
That's off its head, bro. This, I swear, this being here, it's like being in a prison. They lock your gates. They put signs on your door if you mess up. That's
literally a prison, bro. I've never seen no type of shit like this, bro. This is wild, bro. I ain't never seen something like this.
Like jail, bro.
Only in jail. Like, this is crazy, dog. I'm not gonna lie. It don't even really, like, if you look at the scenery outside of some of the houses, it don't look that crazy. But all the other shit that I'm seeing is just wild, bro.
It's like jail, lad. Then they speak to you, they put port. Bro, this is crazy. Police here are out of control. I don't know, maybe they have to do it. Maybe the people here are out of control.
The other bottlers usually have like it caged off.
Well, where is the alcohol here?
They even close off all the deodorant here now. Nah,
do they?
They lock up all the deodorant because the young people need to walk around and cram it all.
Yeah. No way.
If you walk in a Woolies, it's only behind a counter. Cabinet.
Like your normal links.
Oh, they let us in?
Yeah.
They know who I am?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. All right, we've got special access into the alcohol room.
This is the VIP room.
Yeah. Without the permit, we got in here.
So you go to Woolworths and they have the deodorant cans in. Cabinet, locked cabinets. Because a lot of the kids are.
So you have to go to the counter and ask them, and they'll unlock it for you.
Really?
Because they'll chrome it. We'll chrome it with a spare shirt.
They steal it so they can chrome it.
And they inhale it and get high in that.
Yeah. Inhaling deodorant is crazy.
Is that a thing? All right. That brings me to. Is like the drinking petrol or sniffing petrol and stuff. That's a thing here.
Yeah.
Obviously, like in Sydney and Melbourne, they say in the Northern Territory, they sniff petrol and stuff. So that's really a thing.
What the fuck?
Oh, no, really?
It's like
you know what I mean? Like, you're just breathing in the fumes.
And, like, young kids?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And glue.
Yeah, back in the day at Palmer Bus Depot, you'd see, like, young kids, bro, like, hung out, bro, like, with a deodorant can. Like,
that's even around here. It's not, like, an Alice Springs thing. That's everywhere.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah. Hey, doing, mate? How are ya? You're in the show, too, mate. How are ya? All right, we're going. We're cruising. Sorry for harassing ya.
Yeah, there you go, Elliot.
But even in some communities, we've heard of stories of them licking cane toads as well.
Licking cane toads?
Yeah, like the back.
That's crazy.
I said that before. I was like,
she's boss.
What's it like having a shop here? There must be headaches every now and then.
Hey, y'all need to get some weed up over there. Y'all need to get some weed up over there ASAP because that ain't it, bro. Trust me. You know what? I got a solution. Y'all need to legalize weed. Start growing some fire-ass kush up over there and just, you know, let everybody just build a couple dispensaries, let everybody smoke some weed, bro. You know what I mean? Because I guarantee you, everybody start smoking some weed and stop inhaling deodorant and sniffing petrol and doing ice and all that other shit and drinking way too much, you're going to be off the kush, off the good kush blunt, you feel me? You're going to be off that good kush blunt, chilling, bro. You're gonna be like, man, I ain't even really trying to fight nobody right now. Shit, I'm trying to play Call of Duty. I ain't even really trying to fight nobody, dog. Keep it real with you. I'm just trying to chill tonight, dog. I'm just keeping it a buck, bro. We can't have kids sniffing petrol and doing ice and sniffing deodorant. Like, that's crazy, dog. No wonder you got people wilding out like that, man. Just get them some good kush. You know what I'm saying? Get them that good Afghani. You know? Some blunts, some grabber leaves. We gonna be smoking. You feel me? Chilling, bro. Chilling. Ain't trying to do nothing. You know what I mean? That's the solution. I got it. Boom. Bro, you smoke a Kush blunt and drink alcohol, you're going to get cross-faded. You're going to be chilling, bro. You're going to be chilling. I'm chilling, dog. Shit. Play some music. We catching a vibe tonight, dog. We kicking back, bro. We ain't doing with none of that extra shit, bro. Know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping it honest, bro. Keeping it honest, bro. That's what y'all need.
Oh, yes. It's like I said, drama and karama. Malak is just, yeah. It's fun.
From what all the boys are telling me, I could imagine having a shop like right in the center of it.
Yeah, it's good fun.
Yeah. See you later. Thank you, Merry Christmas.
Hey, she like shit. We making money.
Can
so
we
fun.
Cruise from here up to Litchi's?
Yeah, my mate's coming with my car now.
All right, mad.
Why'd you put the visor there? Right, it falls down.
Stay ready, ain't gotta get
sorry,
ready.
Sorry, bro, I just exposed your machete. Trying to fucking. So I've gotta move it. I've gotta move it. There you go.
What suburb is this?
This Noora on the left, and then you got
Wallagi
on the right.
Wallagi on the right.
Yeah. Yeah. That's where I grew up in Midmas, Wallagi.
Oh, yeah.
Majority of the difference I've noticed between Darwin and maybe Sydney is like we have more drunks out about than you have, you know, someone
junkies.
Cooked.
Heroin's not a thing here.
Oh yeah,
heroin's like barely a fucking thing here. It's ice. It's
ice and alcohol.
Yeah.
And chromie.
So it's a lot more.
See, ice is an upper too. If they was off that, if they was off the H, bro. They be slumped, you know what I mean? That'd be zombies. That's zombie land for real. You be slumped, but you off that ice, bro. You up, and you mix that with the alcohol. You up, bro. You a superhuman. You a superhuman with too much energy for no reason.
Well, and shit, you don't really see cunts in the nod. You more see cunts getting out.
Yeah. What's this place people were saying? Baguette or something?
Oh, Baguette's Baguette. A community, bro.
Oh, is that?
Yeah.
Oh.
So it's community people in there, you know?
Yeah.
You won't see any white
guy out. Yeah.
Same thing again, like, if I was walking through there at night, I'd get, like, probably started on just because I'm white type shit.
Yeah, a young fella got stabbed there, we grew up a few years ago, he got stabbed there by his own cousin.
His own brother.
Over cigarettes, but it was over a 50 bag or something, stupid.
Wow.
So you can see, like, those are the tall building there, that's the, like, the uni flat.
Yeah.
For, like, the university students, and then, like, right next to it is, like, the shopping plaza.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, the bad bus depot and shit.
Well, what happens at the bus depot?
Oh, fucking, just drunk everything. Shit.
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
I've seen get dragged off the bus.
Oh, that's like,
a move, and they're, like, pissing all over themselves and
that's
shit.
Like USC.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah. Always fights there, bro.
Right,
it's
in
just
the
like
hood.
A hangout point for the drunks.
Yeah.
Everyone going... Community people?
Oh, a lot of it.
Yeah.
Not all of it. A lot of it. A lot of them live here full time.
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of long grasses too.
Yeah.
Meaning, so they actually live in the bush here.
Oh, yeah?
Like
yeah.
Around. They legit set up camp in the bush.
So, like, they're basically homeless, but not really. You know what I mean? Like, that's what they want to do.
So, within Darwin itself, not a separate community, in the bushes, people live in it. And, you call them long grasses.
Yeah.
Because they live in a long grass type of shit.
Wow.
It's not a derogatory term, it's just a...
That's what they call themselves.
Long grasser.
So it's essentially a homeless person, but that's what they want to do. That's what they want to do.
A majority of them are indigenous.
It's like a gypsy or some shit.
I could imagine.
So,
yeah.
But then again, like, you might have, you know, parks that open to the public.
Yeah.
They set up camp there and they're drinking all the time. There's rubbish everywhere. The cops have to move them all the time.
Yeah. Oh, so they take over, like... parks and stuff and get kicked out.
Not so much like your everyday park. Like, they're like, you know where you'd go, there's like little lagoons and like big parks, like big ones. But even up here in Darwin they have Larrakia Nation, which is basically
Aboriginal police.
Oh yeah?
So they come in, I don't think they hold guns or anything like that, maybe pepper spray.
They're more like giving a ride home
if they're too drunk.
So they can't like arrest them, but they can like, they offer them a lift home, you know? Type shit.
Yeah.
They drive around and like, it looks like a paddy wagon, but it's yellow. Yeah.
And so they're closer to community workers.
Yeah.
Larrakia Nation, they're called. Yeah.
And they don't have red and blue lights, they have green lights. It's
once like town closes, bro, and everyone kind of goes home, all the creatures just come out.
No way. Yeah. So like down near where I'm staying at the waterfront.
Yeah,
so
yeah, you're near the club.
Go like along Mitchell Street, bro. That's like the main street through
Mitchell Street?
Yeah, that's the main like.
Is that where the plaza is? The walkway?
Yeah.
That's Smith Street.
Alright. Yeah. But it's near there?
But that, it connects into it, yeah.
So what, I should wake up early in the morning?
Have a sus, bro. See some creatures around on
it's more about like when people are kicking on, you know, like 3-4 in the morning.
Oh, it's
that's
about
when
them?
You see wiggy shit. Like fights, heaps of fights every night in town, bro.
Do you see people sleeping with each other on lawns and shit?
You always see white people sitting down with the long grasses, like eating pizza with them and shit.
What the
hell?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unstacking those electric scooters left, right, center.
No way. Every...
So that's Litchi's.
Oh, this is Litchi's. Yeah. All right.
Litchi's. Yeah, it looks like a project.
Yeah.
Could literally patrol it out of their house with crossbows and shit.
No way.
Yeah, like it used to be way worse than what it is now. A lot of drug deals in there and shit, a lot of burnt cars in there before.
Yeah.
You might see a burnt car in there now, like just depends on what happened over the weekend. Yeah, these are the boys that I told you about.
Yeah.
I said I'd bring you to Litchi's this weekend. Yeah, these will never leave this suburb, bro. They left Litchi's, moved across the road, and now they're getting
he got the mask on like, for real.
Too, you know? Yeah.
Glasses too.
And what, you grew up in Nala?
Yeah, I grew up in Brisbane.
Yeah.
Yeah. Grew up in Goodna, Nala.
Yo.
Ipswich. All the hoods.
Yo. And you came out here, how long ago?
Probably 5 years ago.
Yeah, mad.
Yeah.
Oh, straight away, it's bad here.
This is the hood.
Yo.
Yeah, that's the projects. That's like what?
Hey. Doing. Hey. How are ya? I still can't get over how they put that on people's houses, brother. No alcohol. Bruh.
Yeah,
and what happens if you rip it off? They come charge you. They come fuck.
Yeah,
man,
bruh. Stop anything.
Yeah, it doesn't stop anything, eh?
Yeah, it don't stop shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, they send police around here every day too.
Yeah. Hey, Tupac pumping, bruh. Not enough people pump Tupac nowadays, bruh. Yeah?
I was bumping Tupac yesterday.
Nah, what's humbug?
Like, you know, when people constantly money, like annoying.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
Like a bludger.
Yeah.
No bludgers. No alcohol, no bludgers. No humbug, they call it.
Yeah, that's a project for real.
Like that paint job. Yeah, my paint job, lad. Well, that's dumped. Home gym.
Yeah, that was my old gym.
Was it?
Yeah. I just gave everything to him when we moved out. I was in jail for 2 years.
So is this spot, this where everyone hangs out, in this cul-de-sac here?
Yeah, this is the main spot.
Sometimes this whole store will be packed where we just drink
just
and kick it back.
Just embarrassed stories too, like people have died here and like a lot of deaths.
Oh,
like,
really?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, like a lot of deaths have happened in this spot.
Why am I on it?
No way.
There was one death that was happening.
Yeah.
We were living there at the time and the police knocked on the door and supposedly up on the other side, one woman got raped by her man and her man's family and they cut her head off and walking around with her head around the place, you know?
What?
They cut her head off and they were walking around here with her.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's pretty crazy.
And then,
he said they cut her head off and was walking around with her head. God damn, bro. Stay safe out there, man. The world is fucking crazy, bro. God damn. Hey, I'm about to reset real quick. We'll be right back.
There it is. The alleyway is closed now. So when I was living here, a 12-year-old girl got to death. Like, been killed to death. And that was like the 8th death inside the alleyway.
In this one alleyway?
Yeah, if we want, we'll go.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, let's go.
Well, they fenced it off now, what?
Yeah, it's all fenced off now. There's a tree here. Somebody hung themselves in the tree, so it's gone now.
No way. Someone hung themselves in between these houses.
Wow.
Wow. Craziness.
Imagine a kid or something seeing that.
It's water leaking out of it. Out of the front door. Brother, water's leaking out of the front door, bro. Straight out the shower, straight out the front door. Yeah. What?
That was like the 8th death that happened there, so as far as I know, that was the 8th death.
8th death in this alleyway?
Yeah.
bro.
Like the rest of them have been like a bit older, but yeah, when that 12-year-old, they just closed the
12-year-old girl, that was too much.
Yeah. So suppose when she was drinking with her family and that was obviously went for a walk and yeah, it's been closed ever since.
Drinking with her family, bro, 12 years old.
Sometimes when we were living here, I'll open it, get both doors open and walk down to the shops.
Oh, that's sad, bro. That's bad, eh?
Yeah, it is. It's a pretty bad poverty around here. Bad,
yeah, and that's happening, and there's just balconies just here, bro. Like, yeah, there's people here.
Yeah, literally.
Yeah, wrong here.
That's what I just explained to him about all the deaths that's been here, right? It's been a few deaths.
Bro, I've seen cats get stabbed with pencils and all, bro. You
know? Oh, yeah?
Yeah,
bro. John Wick's been here, guys.
Bleed out, bro.
Pencils and all, eh?
Yeah, bro.
Just anything.
Yeah, bro.
What's your name somewhere, guys?
Write my name somewhere. Yeah, yeah, give me a text, then I will.
Oh, he's done this before.
This one old girl, she was like paralyzed, bro, in a wheelchair. These mob didn't want to look after her. They slit her throat in the back. In the back toilet area, it was all blood everywhere on these flats on the other side.
No way.
Yeah, bro. Forensics for like
they didn't want to look after anymore. They just knocked her.
Yeah, it's full of slice,
the head
bro.
Got decapitated.
Yeah, bro.
And they found the fella. He was walking around here. So like he was walking with a head with the alcohol. Shut up, you know?
What the fuck?
And they found him from here all the way to Karama where you just came from walking with the head. Yeah,
that's where he got picked up.
Yeah.
It was like the next night or something.
I remember the morning.
When was that?
Bro decapitated a girl, took her head, went from the other city, the other suburb, all the way to that suburb with the head overnight, dog. Talking about shut up. That's insane, bro. That's a different level of, just brutality, dog. That's crazy.
A couple years back?
I was like, no, a year and a half?
Yeah.
Oh, what?
Yeah. That long, like, recent. I've only been out of here just for like a year and a bit now, so.
Yeah.
I've seen like people's head get stoned, I've seen brains, I've seen that it works. And that's just me being here for like 3 years.
Yeah.
He's been here for 10 years, so I could imagine what.
He would have seen craziness, bro.
Yeah. Domestic violence is the main thing, though. That's the worst, you know.
Yeah.
You see people fighting with their missus and then they kill them and then that's it, you know. Bottle their missus and then everywhere all over the streets. Bloody.
Wow, that's crazy.
It's one of the worst places in Darwin. It is one of the worst.
Just because of how multicultural this place is.
It used to be in Narrows, but they knocked that down. The next
and
best
thing is the Chiefs. Yeah. All the countrymen and stuff that come and go, you know, none of them. Actually from here, Olivia. They all come from the communities where there's no growth.
So they don't care, bro. They just come here.
They come here, get on the ice, get fried, get horrors.
They come here with the intention of carrying on,
exactly.
It's like a party to them. Yeah.
Exactly, they'll come here and drink and go up, and then they're not allowed to go back to the community.
Yeah.
And then they get stranded in Darwin. They go to housing. This is where housing is.
Exactly,
I'm not even from the community now. This is where housing is. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
This is the first resort, like put him in Litchies or put him at the Narrows.
Yeah.
You're right, Uncle?
He's spinning out, like,
come over this way.
Oh, he tweaking.
Ashley's rocking up.
Come over this way.
He don't even know what's going on.
Yeah.
Those stories of what happens down there is crazy, off its head. Decapitations and murders, wow.
You should have met Ben Hoffman. He done a mass shooting up here, bro.
He's done that mass shooting.
Maybe a year and a bit ago, 2 years ago.
Did he?
Then went to jail.
Killed like four people, injured a couple more.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He's from around here?
On ice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That ice, bro. I'm telling you, y'all need to get some kush, bro. That Afghani, bro. That private reserve, that OG. Get off them drugs, smoke some weed.
For the black people, they give half on this type of card here.
Oh, yeah?
See, it
says that. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Now turn it around. That's all you can get.
Alright, clothes, food, health items, and hygiene. So half your pay comes on this.
Yeah.
To make sure that you're buying food. And
if you're good with it, they give you a Visa card.
Yep.
But you still can't. You can do online shopping.
You can do online shopping. Yeah. So it's like, bro, it's like a prison.
Yeah, it is.
Like, it's like a prison,
it's
bro.
It's
privileges, bro. Even when they were showing me the lanes, they fence them up, and if you fuck up, they lock up your lanes.
Yeah.
It's like a minimum security prison.
It is.
And then if you stuff up, they go to your cell door and they. Right, and you're not allowed to, you know what I mean? It's like jail, bro.
It's
not
in jail, though.
It's just fucked up.
Yeah, it's on the outside. So they get their pay on that card, and then the next level up is like an online shopping card.
Yeah,
and even sometimes they stand at the front and they tell you, we will buy your groceries with this card if you get us alcohol.
Oh, yeah? So there's ways around it, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, man, people been doing that with, in over here we call it EBT, right? I forgot what it actually stands for. It's called EBT, and it actually stands for something, but we just call it Eat Better Today. Because you can get food, and sometimes you might get cash where you can buy certain shit with. You can only use the EBT card in certain different places, right? But a lot of people, they just use the EBT, the food stamps or whatever, and be like, yo, I'll get you hella food, but you got to buy me this over here. Go get me some drink or something like that. So same shit.
There's another way around it where with these cards you can go and buy gift cards and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
But they clicked onto that, you know, so you can't buy gift cards.
They buy like Apple store cards and that, yeah. People. And is all of that stuff new or?
That's been around for a long time. Yeah.
Long time.
Yeah. That used to be a park right here for the kids.
Yup.
And then they knocked it down because people were hanging themselves on it.
On the equipment?
Damn, bro, hanging yourself at the park?
Yeah,
no,
fights is happening, people kill themselves depressed and everything.
Yeah.
Damn, bro.
Yeah, that's bad, bro. So they took everything out of it.
Yeah. As I noticed, they only do stuff when a kid gets hurt.
Yeah.
Killed, but like they let it go on, and then once a kid is involved with the community,
then they change something.
That's when they choose to do something about it.
This is the UFC Octagon.
The UFC Octagon, hey?
Yeah, this is where
it all
happens.
Yeah? This is the patch, eh? You aren't on?
That's the Rumble. Yeah. That's the Rumble Arena.
Oh, yeah? Mad Swags,
yeah? A lot of blood has been spilled in this.
So the equipment would have been, like, just here, it seems.
Yeah.
All right, sick. That's mad. That's mad, boys.
That's Litchi's brightest Darwin. This is Darwin's worst areas, lad. Later, boys.
Later.
Bro, I'm on the way back, bro. I met the boys at the... Where are we?
Kazrina.
The shop's here. There, boys. I don't know.
Oh, that's the homies.
I'm cruising back to the city.
That's the homies.
It was the best, bro. Thank you. Laters. The town one's off its head, lad. Hey. What do?
Oh, shit. What are you, bro?
It's in, bro. It's my
bro. Oh, shit. Wait, can I take a photo of it?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he in the real hood now.
All right, brothers, later, bro.
Yeah, he in the real hood now.
Watch you on YouTube.
You watch my YouTube,
yeah,
man.
Yeah,
hectic. You're in my next episode, brother.
I'll be watching.
We just got stopped. To buy.
Oh, police stopped the bus?
And I jumped on the
bro, they full pulled us over like they're police, lad, because he's playing music. Look.
I'm asking you to get off the bus. Off the bus, please.
Damn, he got kicked off the bus for playing music. I've seen that before, low key, but. Dog.
And here we are, back where we started. I don't even know how to summarize this. I don't often, at the end, sit down and like do a full summary, but this episode, I feel like I have to. Bro, what the fuck is Darwin, bro? What the fuck is Darwin, lad? I don't even know how to put it into words, but when I went to Palmerston, and I said at the end of that episode, I go, "Far, they're just like us. They're just like the rest of us, you know? They're not much different, the boys up here." I was walking around with the boys in Palmerston and hearing their stories and seeing their neighborhood. It's different, but not much different from Sydney or Melbourne or stuff. Mate, Darwin, bro, this is like another world. This is 1,000,000% culturally completely different in every aspect. Like, the stories, did you hear those stories, bro? We're in a block of flats up in Litchi. Oh yeah, they closed this lane because they raped a 12-year-old girl and killed her. They were drinking with her, so they just took her in the lane. Oh, they took this equipment away because everyone kept killing each other on there, and then they hanged themselves. Oh, that tree, someone just hung themselves. They just cut that tree down. Oh yeah, that house, yeah, I used to live in that house, but they were caring for the old lady. They didn't want to care for her anymore, so they cut her head off and walked around with her. When was that? Years ago? No, it's like last year or something. When was that? Yeah, bro. Hello. How you going? Have a good day. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
I was asleep.
Yeah, go to, yeah. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
No,
I gotta go. Hey, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Did you see on that bus? Like, it's just the people here are so desensitized to it. Bro, I just watched a drunk girl on the bus. Like, and I'm saying, so what? It's just a drunk girl, but just to say how different it is here, I watched that drunk girl go one by one to different people. There was a lady with headphones. What about how they come and rip the lad off the bus? I didn't even remember that because I just watched the drunk girl. Like, there was like a white woman that had headphones on, and she was going up and just like ripping her headphones off her, and the woman was just like, she didn't care.
She's still following him. Quick too. You better get up out of there, bro. I'm just she you know, she need a place to stay or something like that. Probably she's probably trying to get some dick. Probably want some drugs or some money. He need to come to LA, bro. I ain't gonna lie, cause the shit I'm seeing, this shit all normal in LA. You know, the stories of like people hanging themselves and all that, that shit is still like pretty crazy, and the decapitation and stuff like that, but just like normal hood shit, drunk people, fucked up people, people on drugs, people like that and all that shit, people from gangs and all that, that's like, go to Watts real quick, bro. We can go to my auntie house, we can go right down the street. You gonna see a whole lot of all this. I ain't gonna lie to you.
You know how like white people are like uptight and like, oh, like that? And like the white, it was just like nothing. And then she went and the bloke was on the phone, she was trying to snatch his phone, and the bloke was just like shrugging his, like they're so used to it, that a woman staggering around trying to take their stuff off him on a bus. Hey! Hey, you scared the shit out of me. She scared the shit out of me. I thought someone was trying to snatch the thing, bro.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
Yo.
You'll be in my YouTube show. For some was this? All I seen was his hand come and try to grab the thing. Imagine that in Sydney or anywhere, cuz. Even in the worst areas, in anywhere. Like that stuff, people would be like, what's going on? Here, it's just like there's a mosquito. Like it's that natural. I don't know, bruh. This place is crazy. Everywhere is something. Down this bus stop, there's a bus stop down here. Look, there's just a whole bunch of people drunk at it. Look, there's police there. Doing things, look. Something's happening there, look.
Oh yeah, I can show y'all a few bus stops like that.
Oh no, it's the transit police. There they are again. Look, they're arguing with some lad. Look, he's in their face. Life in Darwin, bruh. I've seen nothing like it. Nothing. Nothing, cuz I went to the worst gypsy ghetto in Bulgaria. That's like, I don't know, cuz, if civilized is the word, but I'm not trying to be harsh to Darwin, but lad, like, just the state of this place, the crime stories that I was hearing, like, they're not even crime stories. Oh yeah, everyone just kills their girlfriend and rapes their daughters and cuts their grandma's heads off and hangs themselves. Like, there's something way, way deeper wrong with this place than goes by the description of a hood. This is way beyond an episode of Into the Hood. It's just sad on a way different level. Big eye opener, mate. They said that if I come back to that next street here, well, anywhere in here, tonight's Friday night, and it's 10 to 7. They said if I come back here past midnight, the entire place, in the streets, in the parks, in the main street, people have sex on the floor and they bash each other everywhere and hit each other with poles and that every weekend. Like, that's completely normal. Ah, bruh. And that's into the hood, Darwin, bruh. Darwin's most dangerous suburbs.
Damn, bruh. Hey, what did I say from the beginning, bro? I can already see where it's going, bro, because, like, there's places in LA that's like that. Don't go there at night. You know what I'm saying? Don't. It might be during the day, it's still fucked up, but it might be all right. But don't go there at night. For real. There's places like that. You just don't want to be there. You don't want to go. Don't want to see it. What, MacArthur Park? You know, like, that's, you're talking like an area like that. That's like MacArthur Park. That's right over there by Koreatown. That shit is fucked up. You don't want to be over there. Especially at night, dog. You're going to get robbed. You're going to get killed. You're going to get girls getting raped. Dog. There's all types of drugs, all types of crazy shit. So, damn, bro. Like I said from the beginning of the video, you treat people like animals, they're going to act like animals, bro. You got to find other ways outside of just security and restrictions and all of this. There's other ways to try to rehabilitate a community, and you don't do it with the idea that we're going to rehabilitate the people who are already fucked up, but you do it with the idea that the youth and the kids who grow up in this community will end up seeing, you know, being better than the people that came before them. That's what I'm saying. You can't just change, you know, a 30, 40, 50-year-old person who's fucked up in the head and ain't shit. But what you can do is take that kid who's seeing all this fucked up shit around him and give him more outlets so that they don't grow up and do the same exact thing. Anyways, that was it. I know that was long, but that was definitely a necessary video. I almost wasn't going to do it, and I'm glad I did. I hope a lot of y'all see this. I know probably not many people are going to watch this, but I hope a lot of y'all see this, man. And I hope y'all got to the end, too. Anyways, that was it. That was it. Thank you for watching, man. Remember to keep it real. Real is rare. Real always reaches everyone. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.